What is going on, guys? Today I want to talk a bit about Alpha 1, what we have been shown on it, and how the recent teases and streams Intrepid has shown has come a very long way from where they were. As we gear up for Alpha 1 to kick off, Intrepid has done a great job showing us the development of the game through their monthly live streams and blogs, taking us through the creatures, environments, and more. But until last month, we hadn't really seen any true gameplay on the game for a while now. The last thing we got was the pre-alpha footage they showed a little over a year ago, and that pre-alpha footage didn't really show us what we were hoping to see. We saw the devs embark on a quest with some very incomplete quests, bulky animations, and some non-polished graphics and animations, which you know is what is expected for pre-alpha footage visually, but people were hoping to see more out of it, especially since Ashes of Creation has faced many delays and changes through its transparent development process, which tends to happen, but people normally don't see this as much as devs aren't as transparent with the community for this reason. Fast forward over a year and we get our Alpha 1 stream last month, and we can see the game has come a very long way in fulfilling some of those promises on a great MMORPG. As we see active node progression, showing us the stages of development, quests, caravans, node mayoralship and upgrades, and so much more is shown in a beautiful open world game. Along with that, we are seeing a lot more of the completed core classes, a lot closer to how they are supposed to be played, although not showing us the hybrid class system yet. It is giving us a base of what is to expect, even though these aren't the final representation of the class. I gotta make that clear, this is alpha. We are going to see these classes continue to change and develop and gain new skills and lose skills and so on and so forth. Along with this, the second stage of their hybrid combat system is showcased with smoothed up animations and spell casting effects. Although still not the final rendition of combat, there is still a mix in this between the tab targeting and the action combat. Then this last month, at the end of April, we got a non-instance dungeon preview, showing us more of that hybrid combat system, showing the mix again of tab targeting and action combat, and giving us a glimpse of how dungeons will work in the game. So far, we have seen gameplay on the cleric, a spellcaster, and a tank class, all having a variety of unique abilities, making each class feel like its own, with a range of abilities that can be used, though in the final rendition of the game, you will at one point be able to combine two classes to make your own and further customize how you play, giving us up to 64 class combinations. Alpha 1 is definitely ramping up in development as it sets to launch for Phoenix Initiative backers in May and continue to let more Alpha 1 members throughout the summer. What they are showing us is starting to rejuvenate that hype for this MMORPG that has spent years in development, hopefully filling the void in players' hearts. The world itself is built in Unreal Engine and looks absolutely beautiful. Everything about the world is phenomenal, and now things are more fine-tuned, the animations are getting better, the combat is more fleshed out, and the game is really shaping up. There is still a lot we haven't seen yet, such as more of the races, ship and naval combat, in-game castle siege, and much more. But you also don't want the entire game to be spoiled before its launch. Although this will be difficult because the world is ever-changing. Each server is different based on player choice, keeping everything feeling unique. One server may have something that another server doesn't, and it's only alpha. There is an entire world of Vera out there to explore, and loads of more content to be put into the game before it launches. What are you most excited for in Ashes of Creation? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you haven't yet and are interested in signing up for Ashes and helping out the development by backing the game or just wanting to jump on the forums and chat, feel free to use my referral link in the description below. Otherwise, be sure to click on that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, and stay tuned for a lot more to come.